I wanted to finish reading 10 books last month, but I could read only 4. But the ones that I did read were really good. I read one contemporary fiction, one forensic thriller, and 2 business books. And in this video, I'm going to tell you about all of these books. So welcome to a new mini book reviews video. And hi there, if you don't know me, I am Manpreet, India's leading books YouTuber who makes videos about books to help people develop the habit of reading and discover new books. I make a lot of book reviews and recommendations on this channel. If you're new here, just subscribe, follow me on my social media, and also subscribe to my weekly newsletter so that you get all my content updates in one email every Wednesday at 8 a.m. So without further ado, let me talk about the books that I read last month, okay? The first one, I'll talk about the forensic thriller that I read, which is Murdrum, The Probe Begins by Dr. Sohil Makwana. This is, I believe, I might be wrong in this, but I think this is India's first forensic thriller. Now, forensic crime thriller genre is something that is quite specific to doctors. Most of the medical thrillers, forensic thrillers that are written out there are written by doctors. And that is the case with this book as well, because Dr. Sohil Makwana is an MBBS MD doctor, and he's also a COVID warrior. And he has also decided to help out other COVID warriors from what he earns through this book. So that's a very good cause, but I, as a reviewer, I was working with the author of this book, and I do not let my views get changed because of that. I read this book and I actually really liked it. I liked the forensic part of the book. I have done a full review that I'll link down below in case you want all the details. What I did not like about the book was the ending. I felt like that was a little bit unsatisfactory. There is a sequel planned to this book, so in a way the author has just left a lot of things so that he can cover it out in the sequel, but I do not really feel, you know, satisfied with that. I feel like there were character arcs that could have been completed. Of course, when you are planning a sequel, you leave a few things out, but still, I felt that way about this book. I feel like the story, the ending was a little bit unsatisfactory, but otherwise, it is quite thrilling. There are so many plot twists. You are just thinking, you know, this happens, this may happen, and all the things that you are imagining, something else happens. So that is something that I really liked about this book. Overall, I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. And yes, that's what I think about this book. In case you want to check out a forensic thriller, do watch the full review and then make your decision about it. I will leave the links to all of these books down below in the description in case you want to buy these, okay? Okay, so that was book number one. Book number two is Let Love Take Over by Thomson Robert. This is a contemporary fiction. And Thomson Robert is an author I have read before. Alumni of the Year was one of my favorite books of 2019. And Let Love Take Over is his third book. This is a story of a guy who is working in a leading bank, and he has a soul-sucking boss, and things are not going that well in his personal life as well, because he's sort of like, you know, separated from his wife Susan. They are taking a break and all that. Why is that so? There is a major trauma that happened in Josh's life before, and his trauma is sort of affecting his personal and professional life now. So that is what the story is about. I think by the time you watch this video, the review video of this would be up. So do check out the full review video. Honestly, I feel like this is a very short book. Written well. The way the author has dealt with this story in so less amount of words, it's really appreciable. It's really good. But I feel like this book is specifically written for people who are young professionals and who read every once in a while. If you're a regular reader who wants to dive into long novels, you might feel like, it was too short. But otherwise, if you're a professional who just likes to read short books, you will like it a lot. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars, and do check out the full review of this book in case you want to, you know more about it. Now, coming to the 2 business books that I read. Actually, I've been sharing a lot about my reading goals and stuff like that on my Instagram. And if you have followed me there, you would know that one of my goals of 2021 was to read 13 non-fiction books. And there's another goal that is to read 12 business/marketing books. Now, I have actually, drum rolls please, achieved my goal for reading 13 non-fiction books this year. Now, it's just about like reading a lot of business marketing books so that I can, you know, achieve that goal as well. This is one of the business books that is highly recommended. So this book actually studies the various compliance tactics a lot of advertisers and businesses use to sell their product to you. And honestly, this book has been written in a way that it tells you, you know what, this is a compliance tactic and this is how they're trying to exploit you. You can save yourself as a consumer from this. But ironically, what has happened is that this book has become a guidebook for all the advertisers and business people and marketers to actually use these compliance tactics to win more customers. So this has become one of the most recommended, one of the must read business books out there, quite ironically. But I feel like if a marketer wants to sell something of value to somebody, which I like to believe that all the products that I work with, all the businesses that I work with, services that I work with, I try to do something like that, to sell something of value, then using these compliance tactics actually help you out. So yes, it is like a quite a gray line, you know, reading a book that is written to help people avoid falling prey to all these compliance tactics to actually, you know, use more of these compliance tactics. It's actually a gray line, but I feel like as a marketer, if you are selling something of value, it's something you can do. Again, so this is a business and marketing book, so I would recommend it to the people who are interested in this, and not everybody would like it, but otherwise business and marketing people would love this book. And lastly, I read a very short book, Who Moved My Cheese. This is again one of the most recommended books to business people out there. And this book is actually about adapting to change. This is basically a parable, that is a small story written to just make a point or inspire you about something. And what this story inspires you about is being open to change. So the parable in the book actually features four characters: two mice, Sniff and Scurry, and two little people, Hem and Haw. And these people always go out on a hunt for cheese, and that's how, you know, the whole name of the book comes from, Who Moved My Cheese. And basically it's about, like, you know, adapting to change. I feel like this is a very short book, and I am not that comfortable with parables. I haven't liked The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari by Robin Sharma is something that I read a long time back, and back then I felt it was good. I think I even liked it, but now I feel like I'm just not the kind of person for parables. But this book really was thought-provoking for me as a business person, as even an employee, to see if I am being the Sniff or Scurry or Hem or Haw in the story of my life. So it is thought-provoking. It took me just 40 minutes to read this book, so I feel like it was also worth my time, hence gave it 4 out of 5 stars. And I'm just happy that this is one of the books that everybody recommends, and I have read it, and it's good enough. It's very unlike the other book that everybody recommends, that is The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. That is a bad book. But this one was good. So I'm overall very happy with all the four books that I've read this month in July 2021. Though all of those were like 4 out of 5 star reads, and I feel like, you know, it has become a pattern. So I am looking for some 5-star reads for the next month. So let's just see what happens. In my mind, I'm just like, you know, to break this monotony, either I need a book I hate a lot or I need a book that I love a lot. But hate a lot book thing, that kind of gets you in a slump, makes you feel really bad. So I'm just hoping I'll find some 5-star books in August. If you have any recommendations for me, just let me know in the comments down below. And yes, thank you so much for watching this mini book reviews video. I hope it helped you discover some new books and get some quick reviews. For detailed reviews of the first two books I mentioned, check out the links in the description. And yes, this is the end of this mini book reviews video. This might be signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.